We have different type topics which is called high order linear homogeneous differential equation with constant coefficient. What is importance of these topics? The coefficient must be constant. If the coefficient is constant, if you want to use these topics, we will use directly auxiliary equation, or it is called characteristic equation as well. But what is auxiliary equation or characteristic equation? Let's learn by using the smallest highest order, that is second order differential equation. In this topic, this is nth order, and if you realize, all coefficient must be constant. But what is auxiliary equation? If we have this type differential equation, we have to find auxiliary equation. What is auxiliary equation? Let's learn. Let's use the second order differential equation, a y double prime b y prime c y equals zero. Okay, this is second order. By using second order, let's find auxiliary equation. So suppose that y equal exponential rx. By using this information, let's find auxiliary equation. Now I will prove it, but from now on, not necessary to prove for all questions. Directly we can write, but let's learn the meaning of theory of auxiliary equation. So what we have? We need y double prime, y prime, and y for this differential equation. This is y. So we need y prime, take derivative of power, derivative of rx, r, and the same function, exponential rx. Second order derivative, again take derivative, again will be r times r square exponential rx. So let's put this information in the equation. That is, let's substitute. There is a y double prime r square exponential rx plus b and y prime. What is y prime? R exponential rx plus c. What is y? Exponential rx equals 0. And you know, exponential rx is common factor, and here there is ar square, here there is br, and here there is c equals 0. We know that in mathematics exponential rx cannot be 0. This is not possible. Maybe in the limit situation we can mention about the exponential is equal to 0, but here exponential cannot be 0. The expression that makes this part to zero, we have in the bracket a r square b r plus c equals zero. So this equation is called auxiliary equation, or we can say characteristic equation as well. But how we obtain this one? Always we will use this term. No need to use this term here. Look, a y second order derivative. Instead of second order derivative, y, r, 2. Here the order 2, power is 2. Plus b, what is order 1? That's why r to the power of 1. Here, plus c, what is order here? There is no derivative here. No derivative means order is 0. R to the power of 0 means 1. Instead of y, that's why we are writing 1. This is y, nth order derivative will be r to the power of n. For example, y 3 prime. What is order 3? That's why r cubed. What is y? Are there any order here? There is no derivative. No derivative means order 0. R to the power of 0 equal 1. That's why instead of y, be careful, we don't write r. We write r to the power of 0, that is 1. That is instead of y, just 1. If we have y double prime, what is the meaning of this part? This is r here, second order, that's why square. So instead of the order of derivative, just you will write the power of r. This is so important. Be careful about that. Here, let's continue. Let's write auxiliary equation. Fourth order, r to the power of 4. Minus 2, second order, that is order 2, square, plus first order derivative, order 1, plus r to the power of 1, minus 4, instead of y, what we are writing? 1, that's why 4 times 1, it's 4 equals 0. Auxiliary equation. Here, r, order is 3, cubed, plus order is 2, square, plus 4, order is 1, r to the power of 1, instead of y, instead of y we are writing 1 plus 1 equal to 0. This is auxiliary equation. Here r to the power of 5 minus r square minus instead of y write 1, that's y equal to 0. These are auxiliary equation. Instead of the order of derivative, write the power of r. But what is our aim? Our aim is to find roots of auxiliary equation. We will solve this auxiliary equation and we will find the roots. But what we have after finding roots? These roots could be here, maybe they are different. Maybe they are different. What else? These roots, maybe they are same. For example, you found two roots, it could be 3 and 5. You found two roots, it could be 5 and 5. That is the same root. Or maybe they are not real number, maybe they are complex conjugate roots. We have three possibilities. The roots, after finding the roots of auxiliary equation, okay, we construct auxiliary equation, our aim is to solve. After solving, we will learn how we write. It could be different roots, maybe same roots, maybe complex roots. We have two paths. For example, let's learn something about the last things about that. In the next video, we will learn if we have distinct root, okay, different, if we have same or complex, we will learn how to write the solution. But for example, you found roots like 2 and roots and 2 and 5. Let's suppose that. What is the theory? Theory says that here y equal exponential rx. Y equal exponential rx. So it will be exponential. What is r? That is r is 2, r is 5. We found. Okay, these are roots. Exponential rx. The theory says y equal exponential rx. So write r is 2. Let's suppose it is exponential 2x. R is 5. It is exponential 5x. We have two roots. What we learn? We learn that if we have two solutions or three, more than one solution, the general solution will be written as the linear combination of these solutions. So two solutions, linear combination C1, C2, this is our solution. Exponential. So what is format? Linear combination. Why? Because, okay, why we are writing like that? Because the theory says exponential, result is exponential rx. Let's suppose that we found result as 2 and 5. That's why exponential 2x, exponential 5x. We have two solutions. If we have two solutions, we know that. If we have two solutions, we write the general solution as linear combination of them. So that's why C1 exponential, C2 exponential. Always format will be like that. Okay? If you are complicated, just think about format. C1 exponential, stop. First root, 2x. C2 exponential, stop. Second root, 5x. Continue. C3 exponential, what is third root? Right. C4 exponential, fourth root. Okay? It doesn't matter how many roots that you have. Always the format says C1 exponential plus C2 exponential plus C3 exponential. It will go like that. It means linear combination, but it's not necessary to think about linear combination as always. Just write direct linear combination means C1 exponential, C2 exponential, C3 exponential. In the power always will be roots, and roots. This is the format of solution by using auxiliary equation. In the next video, we will continue with if we have different roots, and after that repeated, and after that complex conjugate roots.